Hey everyone, welcome. I don't know about you, but we have been using SRAM branded cranks for quite a while. I specifically liked the ability to change the chain line by just replacing chain rings. In this new iteration of their cranks, the T-type transmission cranks, they introduced a few more changes. So in this video, I'm gonna take a look at the differences between the new and the old SRAM cranks and see if you can use them interchangeably or not. It is Truvative in California that designs all their cranks and bottom brackets. And yes, they are to be thanked for the 28-99 millimeter dub spindle that they introduced a few years back. The dub spindle is one that is carried over to the new crank sets. However, with these new cranks, they have reduced the availability of certain spindle lengths. When it comes to different chain lines, that's how these companies address the needs for 55, for super boost, for downhill spacing or fat. And I have a video talking about Shimano. I'm gonna link it up in the corner. SRAM is no different. They use different spindle lengths for, again, different rear spacing on their bikes. And the new cranks only come with dub wide, which provides you with 55 millimeter chain line, and that's it. Here's the new beautiful XO crankset that is dub. However, this is dub wide, and that means that the length of the spindle is 11.8 centimeters. The same way to take out the slack is involved here on the new cranksets. Just like with the old, this older crank uses a standard dub spindle length, and that comes up to 11.2 centimeters. So there is 6 millimeters spindle length difference between the standard dub and the wide involved by the new T-type cranks. So if you have dub cranks right now, you can easily replace them with the new T-type cranks. And SRAM actually has a really nice table explaining you what bottom brackets and what kind of spacers you should install for the different cranksets they offer. These cranks will also work on bikes that require super boost or 56, 57 millimeter chain line. But again, that would be different than the T-type transmission that is optimized for 55. Why 55? Because many of the current bikes require that chain line anyway, just to make room for fatter tires in the back. And because the T-type cassette is pushed outwards 2.5 millimeters, more about that when I talk about cassettes. The chain line that these cranks provide, so 55 millimeters, is actually no better or worse than the chain line used by the good old Eagle drivetrain. But enough talk about the non-drive side cranks, because here on the drive side is where the major changes are. We're talking about the integrated bash guards and the new chain rings. Old versus new side by side. Here on the dub cap, you're gonna see the 54 newton meters that is needed to tighten these up with an 8 millimeter Allen. As you probably know, these caps tend to migrate out, so you can lose them. You unfortunately need a tool like this to tighten them up. If you lose that cap, you're gonna have to order a replacement that comes with the bolt, and everything else is the same on the XX. It's just a different color. I really wish SRAM stick with the old style where you had a 10 millimeter Allen to tighten this cap, and then you had the 8 millimeter on the inside. The length of the crank is clearly visible here in the back, but it's not at the bottom anymore. It's right there in the middle where the Eagle logo is. And also, these aluminum cranks have a little hole here at the bottom. I don't know if that does anything or is useful for us end users. I assume it has something to do with the manufacturing process. Carbon cranks are still color coded. You have the purple here for 170, which is written right around the hole. The other thing that's specific here is the shape of this crank booth, which has that diagonal cut. This is the old crank booth from SRAM that, by the way, fits right in. Bash guards, they are made out of plastic for the XO. They are made out of aluminum. In case of the XX, they do not exist for the XX SL. And if you flip it over, you're gonna see a couple of things. Number one, they use a different method to attach the chainrings to the cranks. You have 8 bolts over here as opposed to 3 in the old crank sets. Now the old crank sets used T25 to remove the chainrings. The new one, because the bolts are a lot smaller, use a T20 and tighten them to 4 Newton meters. If you look here on how these are attached to the chainring, it's fairly simple. You have 2 bolts on a side. Even these little plates here are specific to the chainring size. These are for 32 tooth, and you see the T25. Obviously, you can remove one or both bash guards if you don't like them. And this crankset without the bash guards, I think it looks even better. Look at that. The XX cranks do not have those plates at the back of the chainring, and you still need a T25 to remove them. They use thicker bolts similar to what we used to use for chainrings. And again, this would be chainring specific, 32 tooth specific. And here they are side by side without the bash guards. Which one do you like best, the XO or the XX? I think I like the look of the XO a little bit better than the XX. There's not a lot of information here on the front of it, aside from the SRAM logo somewhere, and they're both made out of aluminum. XO specific chainring, 3mm offset, SRAM 2 type chain only. Same information is to be found here, and this one is going to specify XX and then the size and very similar information. Interestingly, with these being 3mm offset, that tells you that third parties might be able to give us different offset chainrings to go back to that 52mm chain line if we want to. It wasn't too long ago when I looked at the new T-type chains, and I'm gonna link that video up in the corner. So what does that mean for the current chainrings? How different are these? I mentioned the T20 Torx, and the chainring comes right off. This is how it looks like. Obviously, this is quite a bit different than the old style installation method with the 3 bolts. But SRAM did use the same design on the Road group sets in the past. And when I found out the details of the new chain, I always thought that the teeth are taller on the new chainring. I was very wrong. The teeth are no different whatsoever. Definitely not in height, definitely not in shape. However, because this old Eagle chain is actually thicker and bigger in all dimensions compared to the new flat top chain introduced by the T-Type, you're gonna see that the teeth of the new and the old differ in their thickness by exactly 0.1 of a millimeter. This is the thick tooth on the new, 3.4, and the old is 353. The narrow tooth here is 193, and on the new chainring this is going to be 1.8. so 0.1, 0.13 of a millimeter difference between the thickness of the teeth, with the shape being the same. However, even though this is slightly a bit thicker, it seems to mesh nicely with the new T-type chain. Take a look at this. Look at that. The chain has wax on it, that's why it doesn't fit perfectly. And here's the same chain on a Garbaruch oval chainring, meant to work with both 12-speed Eagle and Shimano HG Plus. And obviously the flat top chain is gonna work no problem with the new dedicated T-type chainrings.
So I would say with a bit of caution that you should be able to use your existing cranks with the new flat top T-type chain if you want to upgrade to the new system and use or reuse your existing cranks. By the way, some of you ask me about the Road flat top chains versus the MTB ones, and the answer is the Road flat top chains are a bit thicker externally, so they would not fit the MTB cassette properly, but I will talk more about that when I do the deep dive onto the cassettes. But let's put these on the scale.
And let's start with the chain rings. And here's your XO at 75 grams, XX at 75 grams as well. And even though they are marked XX and XO here in the back, they're fully interchangeable, no problem. If you're wondering about the tightening bolts, 8 of them, here is 83 grams, so 1 gram per bolt. 170 XX cranks with crank boots are at 423 at the chain ring, and that's 498. Remember, we have to add 8 grams for the bolts. And if I add the little bash guards, 525, one more, 550, so 560 grams altogether. My XO cranks are 165 and they come up to 532 grams. Here's your 8 little bolts, and you add on the 32 tooth chainring, and that is 615 grams. And if we are to add the bash guards, let's add them one by one, 656. Bolt plates and all the screws, this comes up to 697 grams for the XO 165.
So there you have it, guys, the new T-type cranksets versus the old dub cranksets from SRAM. Which one do you guys have? Which one are you gonna keep? Are you gonna replace your old dub crankset with the new T-type? If so, why? Let me know in the comments below. Let me know if XO1 or XO, the aluminum crank, is the reason for that. I definitely like the design of this, and I am considering using one on my newly built Yeti Arc. Otherwise, these new cranks are compatible again with the good old 12-speed chains and with the new flat top chains that I have reviewed recently. So if you like the style, if you like the looks, if you want to be forward compatible, this would probably be the way to go. So what do you guys think? Did you like this video? Let me know in the comments below. I hope you found it useful. And if you did, don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment. And until next time, hope to see you guys on the trails. Cheers, guys. Cheers.